Galloway is a forager's paradise. Its mild, damp climate and wide variety of habitats offer perfect conditions for a vast array of flora, fauna and fungi. Nick has been to a secret woodland with an expert forager.
For a chef like me, every season is special. But in autumn, it's not about the cultivated vegetables. It's what I find in the great outdoors. And there is nothing finer in Scotland at this time of the year than wild mushrooms. Today, I'm joining foraging tutor Mark Williams deep in the Galloway Forest, hopefully to find some delicious edible mushrooms. So there's a real concentration of something here. What we got?
Good? Well, this is exciting. Yeah, there's a proper, actually, side of a ring going on here, isn't there, of mushrooms? So this is the best mushroom for beginners to try looking for in the wild. This is the hedgehog mushroom. And it's called that because it's got little spines on the underside of the cap, and they actually come off. And if you just brush them like that.
And is it a good beginner's mushroom? Because it's very difficult to mistake this for something else.
There are other mushrooms that have spines, but they're quite rare and they don't look this lovely, creamy, light orange colour. These can be from salmon pink through to cream. I always think they look like little puddles of spilt cream on the forest floor.
And they're also delicious, which helps as well.
Yeah.
So when people are starting hunting for mushrooms, what are the golden rules?
Well, the biggest rule of all that covers everything else in terms of safety is never eat anything unless you're 100% sure what it is and that it's safe to eat.
And what's the best way to learn that?
Well, go out with somebody who knows what they're talking about is good. Don't be too ambitious. Start with a few simple species like hedgehog mushrooms. Get yourself a couple of good guidebooks. A big one at home and maybe a little one you can have out in the wilds that you can use on a regular basis when you find things.
And what about the legalities? Can we just pick as many mushrooms as we like?
No, I mean, you know, there are other things out in the woods that are eating the mushrooms and using them, and the mushroom itself, the fungus, is trying to spread its spores using the mushroom. So I have a little rule. In an area like this, I only pick the biggest 50% maximum. And, you know, there are other mushroom pickers out there as well. And, OK, mushrooming kind of brings out that little, oh, it's all mine kind of sense in us. But, you know, there are other people out there who want to enjoy them, maybe just to look at.
So, in an ideal world, which mushrooms would you most like to find?
Oh, there's a lot of good stuff out there, but I would say that everybody, really, every gourmet is after a cep, or what the Italians call porcini.
The penny bun.
And this is the kind of habitat where we might expect to come across a few, if we get lucky. Oh, look at these beauties.
Fly agaric?
That's right, aren't they gorgeous? But definitely not something you want to end up with in your basket. These guys are definitely poisonous and they would make you quite ill, so you don't want to get them mixed up.
Why are you interested in them though?
Well, these are a really good sign that there might be seps around. They like exactly the same kind of habitats, they'll grow with the same kind of trees, and very often where I see these, I'll find seps at some point.
Shall we look?
Yeah. Yes, oh yes, look at this. That is what the French would call a prime bouchon cep, bouchon being the little corks you get out of a champagne bottle.
So I've often wondered whether we should use a knife to cut these or just pull them out.
Well, there's a bit of a debate amongst mushroom pickers on this. I think on the whole, it doesn't really make that much difference. The important thing is not to disturb all the ground around it. Uh-huh. So mushrooms are essentially a fruit of an almost invisible underground network. Mm-hmm. So as long as we pick it carefully and try not to disturb too much of this ground with our feet and as we're doing it, then the actual mycelium that has grown this mushroom under the ground will remain intact. Really sensual, you can actually kind of feel it just kind of coming away, almost with a pop. That is as good as it gets in mushroom picking. That is the king of the wild mushrooms in prime form, and it's going to be good.
It's So all we need is a few more.
Yeah, basket load would be great.
You can really never have too many, that's for sure. So, Mark, as ever, the proof of the pudding is in the eating.
Uh-huh.
And for once, I'm not cooking. Take it away, chef.
All right. I think with you've got ingredients as good as this, keep it simple. We're going to sauté off the mushrooms, the seps and the hedgehog mushrooms, in a little bit of butter oil. Season it up and flambé in it a little bit of apple brandy. Finish it with a bit of cream, and I've got some little herbs that we've just picked round about in this nice little nook that we found.
Do you know what? It looks fantastic, and it smells even better. That's the mushroom and the brandy thing, that's pretty special. So yeah. It's time just to test drive this.
From forest floor to the mouth in about half an hour there.
Wow, that is just extraordinary. Those flavours and the textures are just incredible. And the two of those mushrooms worked, the sep and the hedgehog worked incredibly well together. Mm. An amazing taste sensation that would not be out of place in a fancy restaurant. I mean, a properly fancy restaurant. And the amazing thing about this is it was picked here in Scotland for free. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That was just fantastic.